My name is Ruta, and you're watching 100 Days of Good Hair Days Hair Diary, where I'm doing a different hairstyle every single day, 100 days in a row, and I'm also sharing my moods. As you can see, today is my second episode from far, far away, a holiday destination, which is not so much of a destination for my hair, because I still need to do the hairstyles. I don't know, it's a good thing or not a good thing. Well, honestly speaking, I think what's happening to me right now is like, you know, when you have a marathon and you are hitting the last mile, and it is really hard to do the last mile. Maybe it's because I'm on holiday, or maybe because holiday routine is completely different from the normal routine. It's now for me it's a little bit more tricky to do the hairstyles. Never mind. I forgot to take my book with me, but I'll insert the picture. Today we're gonna do a hairstyle called Low Plaited Messy Bun, and today is day 89. So to do that, we need a couple of hair bands, comb, well brushed or combed hair, and a couple of hair grips or something like that if you have your hair very, very super, naughty. So to start this, it's very simple. We just kind of like brush the hair. It's good to create like a parting at the front of your hair. If you want to do it in the middle, fine. If you want to do it on the side, it's fine. I did it on the side. And the next step is to basically do a 3-strand simple low plait. So that's what I'm gonna do now. So, and my dress is not really very stretchy, so not the best. Okay, I'll try not to tear my dress apart while doing this hairstyle. Okay, so what I do is I separate the hair in 3 parts, and I just create a simple plait to start with. Why did I say we need 2 hair bands? I'm not sure. Maybe we need only 1. So we create a simple 3-strand plait like this. Because my hair is not like a Medusa, I need to put it kind of like enough round to finish the length. And you plait it all the way down up the very tip of your hair as long as it goes, basically. So for me, as long as it goes is approximately up to here. So in here I'm just gonna use both of my hair bands, and I'm just securing the end with the hair band or hair bands, whichever way you have it. Okay, next step, to mess it up a little bit. So to mess it up, let's fluff it up. So don't do anything in here, just kind of like more where the plaiting starts. Pull it a little bit, let it stick out. If you want, you don't have a rear view mirror, but the point is to kind of like make it not super smooth. We don't want to do ballerina, we want to do a messy plait. So, and then to create extra messiness, you can just go like this, a bit like hedgehog looking thing. And then we take the plait, and then we gently put it around, I want to say base of the plait where we started the plait, and then we take one of the hair grips and we secure it. I don't know if I can successfully secure it from the inside out, but basically we secure it with the hair grips. Oh, I can see my cable. So what I did, I secured the bun
with 2 grips, I think probably I could have brought more than 2 grips. And if you have small grips, secure them kind of like underneath, so you won't be able to see the grips. So this is a messy flow bun. It's a little bit more kind of like easy to make, but it can look very classy if you have some pearls or something to add to this. And voila, my mood today. Well, a combination of everything. We are kind of in the middle of nowhere, but now it's Monday, so the buses aren't. So we went to the town center and everything seemed to be going very well. But then, hey ho, the bus schedule and the bus arrival times are not the same. It's like 2 different things. Never mind that, we got the bus and then we managed to go back. And then I think all of the stress of kind of like not really knowing where you are or when you're gonna be where you wanna be. But I must say, later, because we had a swimming pool slot booked, because right now you kind of just go whenever you want. So when we arrived, I was like all stressed, all the arriving and waiting for the bus and, you know, like finally getting the bus and going with the bags over shopping. But then when we finally came back and we went for a swimming, it was probably about like 1 hour session, I could feel like my swimming was not really like competitive or anything. It was just kind of in the water and just kind of letting go of everything. Very good thing to do, to let go any kind of like emotional tensions and kind of just slow down the rhythm, slow down the tension, get rid of the tension, that kind of thing. So the swimming pool was brilliant. Apart from the showers in the swimming pool doesn't work unless you a member and you have a special card to activate it. So after that, well, basically we need to go back and do the shower. So I say my mood was impatient, stressed, chaotic, very satisfied with breakfast. Then it's kind of like a changing. And after the swimming pool, it was fine. So basically, I don't know what else is coming up today. We have a spa book, so I think it's gonna be even more smoother mode. So I say right now I am probably, 7 out of 10, I would say. I feel like I could do with a nap, but at the same time, when you are in the nappy mood, if you go to the spa, it's actually perfect. You get the relaxation that you need. So that's my update for today, and I want to wish for you today also, get the relaxation that you need. It's gonna do lots of good for you. And rent a bike or rent a car if you go to unknown destination, because universe sometimes has a different plan for you than the bus schedule. Okay. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you tomorrow. Bye.